Hello there everybody, welcome into the Matt the Grape channel. Today we are going to be talking about the best performance mods that you can get right now for Minecraft 1.19. And you might be asking, why not just use Optifine? Well, Optifine, at least right now, is not updated for Minecraft 1.19. By the time you're watching this, it might be, but we need mods that are available right now. Now, all of these mods are going to be running in Fabric, and Fabric is a mod loader just like Minecraft Forge is, and it works in pretty much the same way. So I'm going to show you guys how to install Fabric. It's pretty simple. You just go to fabricmc.net, and you'll just go to download here, and then you're going to download the installer and save that to wherever you can easily access. And then all you have to do is run the file, whether that means from a terminal on Linux or opening or running it as administrator from a Windows. Whatever you need to do, just run the file. It'll pop up with a box. It'll pop up with a box just like this. You just want to select Minecraft version 1.19, the most recent loader version, and then you'll just press install. And now it's time to talk about some of the mods that you're actually going to be using in this world. The first one is Sodium. All you have to type in is Sodium mod into Google and it'll pop up on CurseForge. Now Sodium is a rendering engine replacement for the Minecraft client. And of course that increases performance a lot. You can see with the performance statistics right here. And all you have to do is head over to Files and press Download. You can see there's already 71,000 downloads. And again, place that in a location that is easily accessible. And the next mod is Lithium. Lithium goes right alongside Sodium, and it is a general purpose optimization mod. It goes on a number of systems, like it says right here in the description. Game physics, mob AI, block ticking, and it's, again, really helpful. So you're just going to go into Files and download that. And next up is Phosphor. Phosphor is a replacement lighting engine. At least right now it's not updated to 1.19, but I'm pretty sure by the time you're watching this video it might be. So it definitely doesn't hurt to type in Phosphor mod into Google and come check out and see if it's updated. I imagine it will be pretty soon. And then we have Krypton. Now Krypton optimizes the Minecraft networking stack. And then we have LazyDFU. So LazyDFU defers unnecessary initialization work. Now this is really, really helpful for loading up new worlds super fast. And the very last one that we're going to be doing is Iris Shader. So in Optifine, one of the main advantages of using Optifine is that you're able to use shaders. Now Iris Shaders is designed to be completely compatible with all Optifine shaders. It has great mod compatibility, as you can see here. It is actually based off of Sodium, and it uses a special technique for shadows. So all you're going to do is click on Download Now. You're going to go down to Alternate Downloads and download from CurseForge. Head over to Files and download the latest version. Alright, and the next thing to do is to drop all of those mods into the Mods folder on your computer. There are many tutorials out there. I'll just give you a quick rundown. If you're on Windows, all you have to do is press Windows key and R, type in %appdata%, press Enter, and it'll load up your app data folder. All you have to do is open up .minecraft, and if there's not a mods folder already in there, you can just create it. M-O-D-S, all lowercase. And again, if you need any help with that, there are, I'm sure, plenty of tutorials on YouTube about that. Now, if we check out the performance of this world, remember there are no mods enabled. 10 FPS, 7 FPS, really not good at all. But now it's time to test it with the mods. So let's go into our Minecraft launcher. You're going to select Fabric Loader 1.19, press play, and let's see. Alright, this is all of the mods with no shaders. As you can see, we're getting 21, 22 FPS. Although, again, this is not the best computer in the world. Definitely not. Your computer will probably get a much better performance increase. Now it's time to turn on some shader packs. All you have to do is go into Video Settings, Shader Packs, and then turn Shaders Enabled. Select whatever you want, and press Apply. And here's the shader packs. As you can see, it looks really beautiful out here. Although we are still at 10, 11 FPS. Again, I think that your guys' computers will work a lot better than this. Do not take this as what your computer is going to go for. But all in all, those are some great mods. You should really check them out. If you're looking for any alternatives to Optifine, with Optifine, of course, not being out right now. Those mods help me a lot, and I hope they will help you guys a lot too. So that is it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, as well as check out Twitter, Discord, and Patreon links in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.